Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our series that in which what we do, we daily discuss important articles of Indian Express newspaper. So today is 26 October, so let's see what are the important opinions or articles that have appeared in today's newspaper of Indian Express. So this article, if you listen to the states, so this article is in the context of recent results of the assembly polls that were held in Haryana and Maharashtra. So this article is political, so we will not be looking at this article. This Kartarpur milestone is an important article today, so we will be discussing this article. So let's see what the author talks about in it. So basically friends, recently you might be aware that India and Pakistan has signed agreement on Kartarpur corridor. So in which what has been done, both the governments have decided to give, Pakistan has decided to provide visa free access to Sikh shrine from the closest point in India. So basically friends, shrine is located in Kartarpur, so that is a town in Pakistan, and it has important gurdwara that is associated with the Sikh history. So after the partition of India, so that shrine, which was important and is associated with first guru of Sikhs, that is Guru Nanak Dev, so that that gurdwara was kind of, we can say, cut off from the Sikh community due to partition. So that was a kind of we can say an injury to the emotions of the Sikh community. But now to repair that damage, efforts have been done. So in the which context, Kartarpur corridor agreement has been signed between India and Pakistan. So author particularly talks about the situation in which it has come. So it is not just significant from the viewpoint of that it has happened between the two countries for promoting pilgrimage, but also from the perspective that nowadays India's relationship with Pakistan are not that good, because this year has been extraordinarily bad. So so you can see that in the beginning Pulwama terror attack happened, in which 44 CRPF personnel died, and then afterwards Balakot strikes happened, and then after that entire episode of Masood Azhar was also there, designating him the terrorist, global terrorist issue was there, and then afterwards then came the issue of removal of special status of Kashmir, in which both the countries engaged in war of words. So against this backdrop, this Kartarpur corridor agreement is the only positive step. So basically in this step both the countries have shown the maturity to sideline their hostilities and to keep this issue separate from the rest of the relationship. So it was author noted that it was in the interest of Pakistan as well as of India. So because Pakistan has many Sikh shrines that are in its boundary, within its boundaries, so obviously tourism will be kind of, we can say, we will get a big fillip due to this agreement, and also it wants to build a strong relationship with Sikh community. The Pakistan as a government wants to build, want to look as proactive. So in this context, India also don't want to lag behind, because particularly due to the post independence political events that happened in Punjab, particularly the Operation Blue Star and all that issue, Khalistan movement, due to which India also don't want to get constrained by the community. So in this context, the access to the Gurdwara Darbar Sahib, that is in Kartarpur, basically it will heal the wounds that were there left of partition. So then there was an issue of contention between between India and Pakistan relating to the access fee, that is charges over the pilgrimage. So Pakistan has insisted that it will charge US dollar $20 fee for that Pakistan will levy per pilgrim. So in this context, India had demanded that please remove this fee, particularly in the context of religious cultural ethos of the country. But then also the Punjab chief minister has also mounted attack that it is a kind of jizya tax being levied upon Sikhs by the Mughals. So this is playing, in fact it is playing to the gallery, because the thing is, author says that it is not just in Pakistan but in India also. There are many cultural places or temples, religious temples, in which people pay for getting cute darshans or special darshans. And then also India has such type of pilgrimage agreement with China also to the Mansarovar Lake, in which China also levies the fee. And also the fee has been increased a few months back, few years ago. So fee was hiked and no issue was made out of it. So and also in this context, it is not we can say a valid demand, because also Pakistan, particularly if we consider the economy of the Pakistan, which is suffering from great disaster. So in this context, every country has a right to determine that how it can benefit from different prospects. So in this context, this fee, this demand was unfair. So it was wise on it is wise on the India's part that also it dropped this demand. So the amount is basically this $20 amount per pilgrim is protected by the agreement, and any hike, if it happened, will be renegotiated by the two governments. So this is, author in the end concludes that this is like a treaty that was signed in 1960, that is Indus Water Treaty, though which was mediated by World Bank, and here there was no mediation in case of Kartarpur Corridor Agreement. But particularly Indus Water Treaty was also signed in the backdrop of the war over Kashmir, the bad blood over Kashmir that was continuing. And in this context, the Indus Water Treaty has stood the various shocks that have been brought to that this treaty has been subjected to due to the bilateral ups and downs. So hopefully, author also says that we hope that Kartarpur Corridor Agreement will also be such enduring treaty like the Indus Water Treaty. So obviously, in this context, author says that it is unrealistic that this will improve the bilateral relationship, but certainly it shows that the two sides are not entirely without the capability to do this. So when there is so much hostility between the relationship and this agreement has been signed, in this context we can't say that relationship will improve immediately, but certainly if the governments do effort on the both the sides, then situation can improve on the ground. Next article is Easier Does It. So we will be discussing this article. So this is in context of recent release of Ease of Doing Business report by World Bank, in which India has been ranked 63rd and this position is 14 ranks up from the previous year, that is 77. So India's performance in this context of Ease of Doing Business has consistently shown improvement. If we consider India's ranking in 2014, then it was 142, but now we are on the 63rd rank, and in fact we are ahead of many Asian countries with which we are competing for foreign direct investment. For example, Indonesia is at 73rd place, and then Vietnam and Bangladesh. So these countries compete with India to attract firms that are moving out of China. So in this context also, India has been placed in the list of countries that are fastest that are showing fastest improvement, notable improvement. So in this due to this jump in the ranking especially when the Indian economy is facing slowdown, this will be a kind of, we can say, a realistic platform to move into the category of top 50 countries. So also much of the in this context, author talks about how this happened. So you must be aware of those the reforms that were initiated by NDA 1, for example, insolvency and bankruptcy code was brought, and then dealing with construction permits and trade across borders and registering property. All these steps have been taken in all these directions so that the improvement has happened. So on resolving insolvency also, the biggest improvement has happened because its performance has improved on both the time taken for the insolvency process to culminate and as well as on the recovery rate. So the time taken for insolvency has fallen from 4.3 years to 1.6 years. So this shows that it is easy to exit from a business, and in India and also in this context, recovery rate has also increased from 26.5% to 71.6% 71.6 cents on the dollar. So despite this jumping, India has also very clear the government has also very clear responsibility, because much more needs to be done in case of enforcing contracts. So on enforcing contracts, India has a ranking of 163. So this is a quite low ranking. So India can improve on it. And then also we have to improve on registering property, where despite improvements, its ranking has improved from 166 in 2018 to 154. So there is also potential in improving this on this aspect. So India's performance is also can also be improved by easing the compliance cost in case of GST and in general payment of tax, on which India ranks 115. So why, friends, such type of reports matter? Because obviously you will be reading a lot of such articles in which various reforms have been talked about, for example labor reforms and all those. But then this provides you a clear idea that on which fields we have to work. For example, if we have improved our insolvency, resolving insolvency time period, and also if we have improved the recovery rate, and then we have to improve our ranking in terms of enforcing contracts, and then improving on the aspect of registering property, and then in easing the tax compliance. So then author in the end suggests that since these rankings are based only on the performance of a few select cities, so they are unlikely to reflect the ground realities, because India is a large economy. So obviously it is the seventh largest country in terms of size. So also economically it is a vast country with many cities and many metropolis having a different environment or ecosystem for business. So it is important that there is a wide divergence in terms of ease of doing business across the states in India. So in this context, it would be wise that, and the government has also shown the intent to expand the cities list, cities covered by its report, beyond Delhi and Mumbai to include Kolkata and Bengaluru as well. So it is a welcome move. So as some of the areas they are impacted, they are to be improved upon by the state government, so this move could incentivize then states to step up their reforms, because expanding cities falling in different states will then give an incentive to different state governments also, so that they can improve upon such steps that are necessary to be taken to promote ease of doing business. So next article is Afghan Redux. So friends, we will not be discussing this article. So basically this is about the Afghan refugees that came in Pakistan after the Soviet invasion, and the author says that similar scenario can happen now America is preparing to leave Afghanistan. So you can read this article for general understanding, but it is not that much important, so you can ignore it. And next is Gandhi and the poetry of fearlessness. So in this context, this is more of a philosophical essay. So if you are interested, if you are a good reader, then you certainly will get a grasp of this article, because this is very nicely written article, but we will not be discussing here, because it will be a lot of confusion for general students who have just started reading newspaper, or those who have started just preparing for the UPSC, because this article talks about various historical events, and also then how his practice of cyclic resistance and passive resistance worked in the favor of India and India's independence, and not just India's independence, but also in the life of common Indian. So now let's move on to the this article, a glimmer of an alternative. So this also article is not important because this article is also from the perspective of political viewpoint, because this article is on the recently concluded elections in Haryana and Maharashtra. So next article that we will be discussing is a health warning. So this article is important. This article analyzes the India annual India TV report that was released in September. So author says that over the last month important releases have been made. For example, Global Health Index has been released in which India has been ranked abysmally low at 102, and this rank is even below Bangladesh, Nepal and Pakistan. So then author talks about the recent announcement made by our Prime Minister on 2 October that rural India has become open defecation free. So in this context, author says that it is important that we analyze annual India TV report. So in this report, it has been said that over the quarter of TB cases are reported from India. So important thing is that this evaluation of TB report will get give an understanding of how the government's action plan on combating TB is performing, and how government's target of eliminating TB by the end of 2025, how much it is realistic. So this valuation will give an important insight. So in this context, it has been highlighted that 21.5 lakh TB cases were reported in the country in 2018. So this is the highest number of TB cases registered in any country. So then the report says that with the introduction of Nikshay, so Nikshay is basically an app or a web portal on which the healthcare providers can upload information about the patients. If any TB patient has they have diagnosed or they are treating. So in this way, this computer based surveillance program basically for TB patients has improved the the reporting of the TB patient. So this record number of TB patients that have been reported, that is 21.5 lakh, which is highest for any country. So this government says that this has happened. Author talks about that there is some issue with this, because the thing is that first of all it has been noted that there is something social about this problem, that is TB. So it is not just that we can say that if Nikshay has been introduced, then the reporting has improved dramatically. So certainly improvement has happened, but then question is then other factors are also there, like patient confidentiality issues. Sometimes patients don't want to share that information, don't want such information about them is being uploaded. And also then other thing is that there is poor knowledge of notification system. So Nikshay is basically, if there is, it is not necessary that all the private or public, obviously public healthcare centers might be aware of this Nikshay, but it is not necessary that all private healthcare providers will be aware of this this online computer-based surveillance program, that is notification of such a notification. This notification system might not be effectively used. So in this context, one thing which is very important to highlight is that in the last decade or so, India's healthcare has seen privatization. So 80% of the healthcare providers as of now are private. So there are many doctors and clinics and establishments that work in remote areas, and they are private, and it is very much possible that they might not be aware of such a platform. So certainly 21.5 lakh cases, though the reporting has increased, but then this number is again questionable, because how much this reflects the ground reality is a question that can be asked. So in this context, the other thing that author highlights is that 5.4 lakh cases, again here author highlights in the context of private healthcare. So it has been the report has said that this annual India TB report has highlighted that 40% rise has been seen in the reporting of cases from private sector last year. Now 5.4 lakh cases have been reported by the private sector, so this is basically as an increase increase of 40% from last year. So this report, the author says that it appears that the report mentions this fact with a degree of pride, but then author again asks that this can be a question on our entire health, on our entire healthcare infrastructure, which the author says that reporting might also be due to large-scale privatization of India's healthcare, in which India's healthcare, more than 80% of India's healthcare is now being delivered by private health enterprises. So certainly if private health enterprises are more, then certainly their reporting of such cases is bound to increase, because if they are dominating the market. So 40% growth can be laudable, but then it is also this question, this must be a poor news for public health system, that what is wrong with them. And then other thing is that Global Hunger Index report has highlighted that India's rank is 102, even below Nepal and Bangladesh and Pakistan. So this shows that basically how much deprivation is there, because this dietary lack of proper diet is a clear reflection of the inequalities and of the poverty that is there. So it is a direct indicator of inequality. So it has been found in various studies, the author says, that there is a direct link between malnutrition and TB. So the author cites a report that was published in a BMC Pulmonary Medicine Journal from Ethiopia. So where researchers have found that TB patients, the patients who are suffering from TB, 60% of them are malnourished. So in this context, they are suffering from malnutrition. So in this context, author says that the target of eliminating TB by 2025 is again questionable, because if we are faring so bad on global health index, Global Hunger Index, then how can we eliminate TB by 2025? Because there is a direct link, and it has been found that a very distal reason for malnutrition in the community can become a proximal cause for TB. So then other thing is, author highlights that is of the open defecation free status of rural India. So author again says that this is also questionable, because extensive studies are needed to validate this argument that in rural India is open defecation free, and also how much toilets are being used, and functional is another issue. So here author highlights that this National Center for Disease Control has a web portal that is Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. Basically it is run by National Center for Disease Control. So it maintains a web portal that that details the outbreak of epidemic. So since 2009, all outbreaks are reported on a weekly basis. So author says when they look at this database that is maintained by Integrated Disease Surveillance Program under National Center for Disease Control, it has been found that after 2 years the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, the epidemics have continued to occur, and there has not been a kind of significant decline, reduction in the occurrence of vector-borne diseases in the country. So even after 2 years after the launch of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, so this is also a point notable. So in the end, the author says that though intention might be there, the government might intend to eliminate TB by 2025, but then there must be a holistic approach, and efforts are required at multiple levels, that is reducing malnutrition, and then improving sanitation and cleanliness, and then other thing is reducing poverty and deprivation and inequalities, and also other paradigm shifts that are required is more sensitization of approach on gender and towards the underprivileged. So this is all about, friends, today's articles. So these are the three important articles that were there in today's Indian Express News newspaper. So if you like this discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And lastly, friends, I also want to tell you that we have a Telegram channel on which we have more than 14,000 subscribers. So on this Telegram channel, we share various resources that are important for your UPSC CSE preparation. So if in case you are interested to get access to those resources, and if in case you want to remain in touch with various initiatives that we have or we launch for the purpose of CSE preparation, then you are more than welcome to join our Telegram channel. And the link of it will be available in the description box. And lastly, also ensure that friends, you subscribe to our this channel, and if you have any doubts, queries, you can ask in the comment box, and I can also provide the feedback in the comment box. So this is all about today's video. Thank you friends, have a very nice day ahead.